Every Monday when I can, I answer questions from the YouTube community. I'm still digging through a whole bunch from the first episode of this, so let's begin. SpideySensei72 says, "To be honest, I'm ex-military, so I dig the haircut." He's referring to my awful haircut from last month. "It's just so rare to see a white dude with a high and tight that's not cop or enlisted. Anyway, what's your idea of a perfect dinner? What would you order to cook?" First of all, thank you for your service, ex-military guy. Secondly, I cut my hair really short because it grows like weeds. I'm like Harry Potter without the charm or skill set of a wizard. My idea of a perfect dinner would be tough. I like a lot of meals, and I don't like a perfect dinner. I haven't had a perfect dinner yet, so it would have to be something beyond my comprehension. I'm a sucker for a bacon cheeseburger with a nice iceberg lettuce on it, a crisp, rich tomato slice, some nice cheddar cheese, slightly melted, not fully melted. I don't want it eating my burger for me. A nice medium rare burger on the meat, on the ground beef, and a good artisan bun. Nice glaze on top. I'd of course pair that with some nice wedge fries, lightly salted, nothing overwhelming. A good amount of ketchup for me to dip in. For the vegetable, I'd throw some broccoli in the mix with some apple slices to complete the fruit set. Throw some caramel dip on there for me to put those wedges into. I've recently been on an apple slices kick, dipping it into the caramel sauce. It's so good. So good. I'm not a big dessert guy, but I like me some pie. An apple, a pumpkin would be really nice. I like a rich pumpkin pie. A little Cool Whip on the top to kind of ice this sundae, and that would be a great meal for me. If I were to prepare the meal myself, I think one of the better things I make is a chicken Caesar sandwich. I start by preparing and simmering some asparagus on low. I then grill the chicken breasts for 25 or 30 minutes, whatever it takes, to get them nicely done, juicy, yet cooked completely. I then butter some hearty roll bread, just thick bread, but it's got a harder casing. I then throw those on the grill towards the end to get that butter melted in, really infused into the bread grains. During the chicken cook, I whip up a Caesar salad, get that all mixed in nicely, get some croutons in there, some Caesar, of course, as the name goes. And then when it all is said and done, I get the bread out, I put the chicken on, I put that Caesar on, and I lay out three strips of asparagus, close that thing up. It is a beautiful meal. It's a beautiful, hearty dinner. Emmett asks, "Have you gone to the Galaxy's Edge Rise of the Resistance ride? It was amazing for me, except for my sister crying the whole time." Ugh, sisters are the worst, Emmett. Get rid of her. Go on the ride alone or find a buddy to hang. I have not been there myself. I haven't been to Galaxy's Edge. I'm in Minnesota. I don't have access to it easily. I'd have to jump on a plane to go to Florida, I believe. Unless it's also at California Disneyland. I don't know. But it wasn't completed yet when I was there with the family, and then COVID hit, so we haven't been back since. We have no desire to go back right now because it sounds like the lines are a shit show at Disney and all of those types of theme parks, so we're just kind of waiting until things start to simmer down a little bit, like a year or two from now. Nathan Shack asks, "Favorite video game in the last decade?" I just got done sheeting all over that Uncharted trailer recently. I think the Uncharted games are some of the best that I've played in a long time. I know that other video games have done combat better and, you know, other elements of it, but I think the overall packages of those games are so well done, and I love the characters and the story. I've played through them multiple times each, so I'd say the Uncharted saga, the four games plus the side game with Chloe, Lost Legacy, that one's great too. So yeah, I think Naughty Dog did such a good job on those. Last of Us is really cool as well, story-wise, the first one. But I don't have that much fun playing The Last of Us as I do Uncharted. Those games are just so fun to jump in quick, shoot a bunch of bad guys, snap some necks, do your thing, and get out. I've played a ton of games, though. I am actually a big gamer. I was doing Twitch for a little while, but I had to focus on one thing over the other. If you want to check me out there, it's twitch.tv/Adam Olinger. I haven't posted a new video in months, but you can kind of look through some of the backlog. Zachary Sabine asks, "How old are you? Also, how have you been staying fit in the last 2 years? Well, Zachary, age is just a number, but I am a spry 38 years old, pushing 39 come November, late November. I have a birthday coming up. That's going to be a tough one, 39. Just on the precipice of 40. I've seen some coworkers and others recently where I was like, damn, gained a significant amount of weight in a small amount of time. It's amazing what inactivity and being home can do for one. I work out every morning. I think that helps. Dedicating an hour to working out every day, lifting weights, has certainly, you know, paid off. I've been doing that pre-COVID. I'm doing it post-COVID, or I guess during. We're still in it. I go on walks every day with the family. We got back into Pokemon Go just recently again. My son of a bitch buddy, he and his family are playing it, and his kids, and he's like, we're playing Pokemon Go, and that was all it took for me to just fire it back up. And now I got both my kids playing who are addicted, and it's just stupid. We're just stupidly obsessed with it right now for no reason at all. It's pretty pathetic what's going on over at this house. It's a pretty sad state of affairs. But it does get us out of the house walking a bit more than we would normally to hatch eggs and find Pokemon. This is my life at, again, I'm 38 years old. I'm an adult male. Dieter Bastian, if I'm saying that name right, says, I don't know, it's probably out of the question because the internet, YouTube can be a cruel place. Would you consider doing one movie review, doesn't matter what, with your kids together because your son knows Suicide Squad rocks so we can get a fresh perspective on things? I apologize if I mispronounce your name. I see you comment all the time. Really appreciate it. Love the comments, love reading them. My kids haven't been in any videos in a long time, but they actually have been in some. Olivia's been in 2 or 3. I know she did a review when I was doing car side reviews for Jungle Book. It was funny. She's probably like 7 in that video. And she's for some reason got a British accent. No idea where she developed it, but whenever she was on camera or doing like pretending things, she would have a British accent. So it's very funny. It's actually a cool review. I do kind of an artsy shot on it too, a lot of different angles. And since I'm not in front of the camera, I'm able to have more fun experimenting with some of the cinematography. So that's worth watching, I think. I'll try to remember to link it in the description. Also, Connor and Olivia were both in the Jurassic World review, the Movie Feuds episode. It was Jurassic Park 2, or no, what was that for? I think it was a Movie Feud episode. It was Jurassic World, and they were both in it co-hosting together. I really like that video. I think it's hilarious because the kids are both young. Connor can barely talk. I translate much of what he says at the bottom. Olivia's just cringy and embarrassed by him. It's really funny. I'll link that one as well, too. As for doing something now, I don't know. My kids are 9 and 12 now. They certainly could, I guess, if they wanted, but I don't really want to make this a family thing. We did actually a short video. Lindsay, my wife, wanted to do a show on a different channel completely that she was going to do where it was like the Olinger family kind of a thing, but we're so boring and lame. I was like, this isn't going to work. This isn't worth our time. But we did shoot a pilot episode. I didn't release it anywhere. I think I'm going to put that on Patreon. I'm going to try to put that on Patreon soon for people. Just because, you know, it's something for them to watch that actually shows our whole family being kind of silly. So if you want to be a Patreon for even a dollar, you can check that out. I will try to get that out even this week. Owen Menning asks, what is your favorite retro game and what is your favorite modern video game? Well, Owen, I covered the modern game, I think, with the Uncharted series, even though they're not that new anymore. Horizon Zero Dawn, I guess, would be something that I really liked from the last 4 or 5 years. I'm super excited for the sequel. Retro, I don't know. I grew up with the retro shit. I'm retro now. I grew up with the Nintendo, Sega Genesis, Super Nintendo. So a lot of those games I love. The Streets of Rage trilogy I really like. I have the newer one. I played that on Twitch not too long. I mean, it was a while back now. But when the game came out, I played it. Really like Streets of Rage 2. I love all the Mario games. I think they're just fantastic. Even Mario 1 is so, like, it holds up so well. There was a part of me that wanted to start speedrunning it for fun, but God, that would take so much time and effort, and I don't have it. I have to focus on one thing. My problem is I love life so much, I want to try all these different things out. Miles says, how do you decide what obscure Netflix thing you are going to review? Also, big fan, dude, I discovered you on random with the Loki video, and it's been great since. That's awesome to hear, Miles. Thank you. Those TV show reviews take a while to do because, you know, you actually have to watch them all and then talk about them in a way that would kind of cover the whole season. I sometimes think it's not worth my time, but it's awesome to know that some new people are coming in from those videos, so thank you for letting me know that. As for what I watch on Netflix, it's probably just kind of like how anybody else decides what to watch. I usually see what's trending, what shows up recommended on my feed, and I think to myself, is this going to be worth it? Probably not, but could it be worth it from a humorous standpoint if it's going to be so bad I can review it and entertain people? So I usually do it like that. GamerGator asks, have you seen the Bully Maguire memes? I'm sure you have, but still, they're comedic gold. This isn't my first rodeo on the internet. I've seen them. I love them. I think they're great. It's partially the reason I wanted to revisit Spider-Man 3 and see if it was everything it's cracked up to be. And I did that video not too long ago defending the film and how it's aged a lot better than initially thought, and I find myself appreciating it, and partially because of the Bully Maguire memes. They're so freaking good. Cindy Chung asks, were you in drama class in high school? Did you take any classes in college, university that were related to movie making? I've said this a couple times now in the Q&As in the past, but my father died when I was 16 in high school, so my college outlook was not ideal. I did not care at all about college. I didn't care about getting out of bed in the morning most days. So I did go to like Hennepin Tech, a technical college. It was supposed to be a 2-year associates. It was gonna be for filmmaking. I did have some film courses when I went. Most of the time I would drive to the college and then sleep in my car through the class. I went to a different college, Normandale Community College. It was a nice community college. And I also failed out of that one in the first year, I believe. Not sleeping in my car that time, but just not giving a shit about going to college. No one holds you accountable in college. It's not like high school. You don't have a mom and dad yelling at you. You don't have teachers or the school even caring if you come in. You paid them. Like I said, I did end up getting an associate's a third time around after taking a year and just figuring my life out and what I want to do and how I'm going to move on from the loss of my father. I did end up getting a 2-year, no big deal, long, long time ago at this point. The movie making stuff and all that, I learned on my own, pretty much is how it goes. We had the old big camera with the VHS tape. We constantly filmed. Constantly try new things. I watched a ton of behind the scenes stuff back in high school. I was obsessed with watching those, you know, like David Fincher movies like Fight Club, even Home Alone, how they did that stuff. I found it so fascinating. A lot of Steven Spielberg documentaries. And so that stuff really helps. And just experimenting with the cameras and with audio and with just music and how you can really play with that stuff. Having a good group of buddies that were willing to just deface themselves and be stupid with me really helps. That goes a long way. It was all pretty much self-taught. I did have a video class or two when I finally graduated from college at my other, you know, 2-year place, but not a lot. All right, that was another Q&A video. Thank you very much. I'm still churning through those initial questions. If you have something you're dying to ask, you can put it in the comments. I can't promise I'll get to it now, but I would like to address as many as I can from that initial batch still. So look for these every Monday, unless I get sick again or something comes up, but I'm really trying to dedicate this once a week still. Thank you very much. Subscribe if you haven't. Like the video, it helps, I think. And share this channel around. Please share it around. Please join me on Patreon. It's only $1 a month. There's a tier at $1. That's not even like a fifth of a cup of coffee from Starbucks. Skip the tip there and give me one. Just the tip. Just the tip. I know that sounds sexual. It's supposed to. Thanks again for watching the Q&A. You don't have to join me on Patreon. You could join right here on YouTube. You get access to some little icons, little guys. You might see them in the comments once in a while. People have an MF for movie feuds or a Deadpool or whatever. They're kind of fun. They're different. You get perks there as well, like access to The Cringe and other shows that I haven't released on my channel. So you get a little bit something more than just saying, hey, Adam, good job. I support you.